In this video, we're continuing on with the circumference and areas of circles worksheet on the CUDA software website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, in the last video, we went over the area of the circle, which is the measurement of the space inside of that circle. In this video, we're going to talk about their circumference, which is the measurement of the outline of the circle. So essentially the distance from one point on the edge of the circle all the way around and back to that point. Now there's a formula for circumference, and that's circumference, I'll say C for circumference, that's equal to pi times D, where D is the diameter. However, looking at this worksheet for numbers 9 through 16, which we're going over in this video, we're given the radius. So let's write circumference in terms of radius. Well, we know that the radius is equal to half the diameter, or the diameter divided by 2. So if we multiply both sides by 2, that 1 half will get canceled out, since 1 half times 2 is 1, and 1 times d is d, and we'll get that d is equal to 2 times r. So let's write the circumference c as pi times 2r. Now, let's get started with number 9. Our circumference c is pi times 2r. So we'll have pi, and our radius in number 9 is 8 miles, so that'll be pi times 2 times 8 miles. So that'll be pi times 2 times 8 is 16, so pi times 16 miles. And pi, remember, if you don't have the pi button on your calculator, is 3.1416. That's the rounded value we've been using for pi if you don't have that button on your calculator. So pi times 16 equals 50.26, which rounds to 50.3, and that's miles, since the circumference is a distance and not an area, so the units is not going to be squared, it's just going to be miles. And if you type 16 times 3.1416, you will get 50.26, which still rounds to 50.3. Moving on to number 10, writing the circumference formula as pi times 2r, we can see that r is equal to 8.3 yards. So pi times 2 times 8.3 yards, that'll be pi times 2 times 8.3 is 16.6. So pi times 16.6 yards, 16.6 times pi, or pi times 16.6, is 52.15, which rounds to 52.2, and that's yards for the circumference in number 10. So that means that the distance from this point all the way around the circle and back to that point, that distance is 52.2 yards. So imagine stretching that out from the point all the way to the other point in a straight line, that distance would be 52.2 yards. Onto the second page, number 11, circumference equals pi times 2r, where r is 4.2 yards. So it'll be pi times 2 times 4.2 yards. So pi times 2 times 4.2 is 8.4. So 8.4 yards will get multiplied to pi. And 8.4 times pi is 26.38, which rounds to 26.4, and that's yards for circumference. Our radius in number 12 is 6.2 miles. So we'll have pi times 2 times 6.2 miles as the circumference. And when we simplify that, we'll get pi times 2 times 6.2 is 12.4, so that's 12.4 miles. And when we multiply that quantity by pi, we'll get 38.95, which rounds to 39.0, or 39 miles. In numbers 13 through 16, we're no longer given a diagram, but we're still given the radius, so we can still solve for circumference. Remember, circumference is equal to pi times 2r. In number 13, our r is equal to 5.2 feet. So pi times 2 times 5.2 feet is going to be the same as saying pi times 2 times 5.2 is 10.4, and that's 10.4 feet. So 10.4 feet times pi is equal to 32.67 feet, which rounds to 32.7 feet. Now let's go ahead and do number 15 while I'm here. Again, pi times 2r, where r in number 15 is 9.5 inches. So pi times 2 times r of 9.5 inches, that'll be pi times 2 times 9.5 is 19. So pi times 19 inches will give us the circumference of a circle with a radius of 9.5 inches. So multiplying 19 to pi, we'll get 59.69, which rounds to 59.7, and that's inches. So 59.7 inches is the circumference in number 15. Now, back to 14. Again, writing the circumference formula, C equals pi times 2 times r, where r in number 14 is 11.1 feet. So pi times 2 times 11.1 will give us pi times 22.2. And when we multiply 22.2 by pi on our calculator, we'll get 69.74, which rounds to 69.7. However, we still need to include our units. And if our units for radius is feet, our units for circumference is also feet. So 69.7 feet for number 14. And lastly, on this video, number 16. If you haven't already, click the like button and subscribe to my channel. Now, r in number 16 is 9.3. So we'll have pi times 2 times 9.3 inches. So pi times 2 times 9.3, entering all that into our calculator, we'll get 58.43, which rounds to 58.4, and units is inches. So 58.4 inches in number 16. Continue on to the next video, where I'll go over the last part of this worksheet, completing numbers 17 through 27. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment below, and if you haven't already, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your classmates.